Hi, this is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. I'm going to show you how to create a cool-looking interlocking basket weave effect of your photos. This effect works especially well on closely cropped portraits. Open a photo you'd like to use. Open your crop tool and type in 870 pixels for the width and the height. Type in 150 pixels per inch for the resolution. And check Delete Cropped Pixels. This will delete everything around the cropped area. Go to a corner, and when you see a diagonal double arrow, hold down Shift and Alt on Windows, or Shift and Option on a Mac, as you drag it in until most of the head is inside the box. To reposition it, click Inside and drag it so it's centered. Then press Enter or Return. It immediately crops to the width, height, and resolution that you typed in. To see your image at 100%, press Ctrl or Command plus 1. If your foreground and background colors aren't black and white respectively, press D on your keyboard. Make two copies of it by pressing Ctrl or Command J twice. Click the thumbnail of the bottom layer to make it active, and press Alt or Option plus Delete to fill it with black. Make the top layer active, and go to Edit, Preferences, and Guides, Grids, and Slices. In the Grid section, click the color box, and pick a bright color for the grid. Then, click OK or press Enter or Return. Make the grid line every 217 pixels, and divide it into 6 subdivisions. Then, click OK or press Enter or Return. Go to View and make sure Snap is checked. If it isn't, just click on it. To see the grid, go to Show and click Grid. Open your Rectangular Marquee tool, go to the top left corner, and drag down a rectangular selection across 3 columns of boxes to the bottom. It'll snap to the grid because we have Snap checked. Skip one column and hold down Shift as you drag down another rectangular selection across 3 columns. Continue to skip one column and drag over 3. Click the Layer Mask icon to make a layer mask of the selection next to the active layer. Go to the top left corner and drag to the right across 3 rows. Continue to skip one row and drag over 3. Make layer 1 active and click the layer mask icon to make a layer mask of the selection. We can hide the grid now. Press Ctrl or Command H to hide it. Ctrl click or Command click on the layer mask of the horizontal rows to make a selection of it. Go to the layer mask of the vertical columns and hold down Ctrl-Shift-Alt on Windows or Command-Shift-Option on a Mac to make a selection that overlaps the vertical columns with the horizontal rows. Go to Select and Save Selection. When you see this window, click OK. Press Q to make the selection into a quick mask. Open your Paint Bucket tool and left-click inside the second empty box at the top to fill it in. Skip a box and left-click on the one after it. Continue this pattern on every other row. Then, go to the first empty box on the second row and fill it in. Continue to fill in every other empty box in every other row so your final quick mask looks like this. Press Q to revert it back into a selection, and press Ctrl or Command J to cut the shape of the selection from the active layer. Click the thumbnail of the top layer to make it active. Click the Channels tab to open the Channels panel, and Ctrl click or Command click on Alpha 1 to make a selection of its shape. Click back on the Layers panel, and press Q to make it into a quick mask. This time, left-click inside the first empty box at the top left and fill in every other empty box on every other row. Then, left-click on the second empty box of the second row and continue this pattern so your quick mask looks like this. Press Q to make it into a selection, and press Ctrl or Command J to cut the shape of the selection from the active layer. The basket weave effect comes to life once we add shadows to these shapes. We need to clip the shapes to the layers directly below each one in order to restrict their shadows to their respective layers. To do this, go to Layer and Create Clipping Mask. Notice the active layer moved to the right, which indicates that it's now clipping to the one layer below it. We'll clip these shapes as well. Make it active, and this time we'll use the shortcut Ctrl-Alt-G on Windows or Command-Option-G on a Mac. Click the FX icon and choose Outer Glow. Click the color box and pick black. Then click OK. Change the blend mode to multiply and make the opacity 50%. Make the size 40 pixels and click OK. To copy the outer glow shadows to the other shapes, go to the FX icon to the right of the layer and hold down Alt or Option as you drag it up to the top layer. Next, we'll add a texture. But first, make a composite snapshot of your image. To do this, make the top layer active and press Ctrl-Shift-Alt-E on Windows or Command-Shift-Option-E on a Mac. Go to Filter and Filter Gallery. Open the Texture folder and click Texturizer. Choose Burlap and make the scaling 100%. The relief is 1 and the light is from the top. Then click OK or press Enter or Return. This is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. Thanks for watching.